हाँ स्टार्ट कर। यहां लाइट तो नहीं जलानी इधर की?
बोलना।
अच्छा तो चैप्टर तो लगा।
चलिए
अच्छा सो इन दिस जर्नी ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी अंडर द हेडिंग ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक पॉलिटिक्स 10th क्लास वी हैव कम टू द फर्स्ट स्टोरी और फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज पावर शेयरिंग। पावर शेयरिंग व्हाट डज इट मीन? पावर शेयरिंग मीन्स मेकिंग द पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ पीपल और एंश्योरिंग द पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ पीपल पार्टिसिपेटिंग द डिफरेंट इंस्टीट्यूशंस पार्टिसिपेटिंग एंश्योरिंग द पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट सोशल ग्रुप मीन्स एवरी सोशल ग्रुप एवरी इकोनॉमिक ग्रुप एवरी ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल ऑल द इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन डेमोक्रेसी व्हेन वी एंश्योर देयर इफेक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन इन डिसीजन मेकिंग दैट इज पावर शेयरिंग और डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग पावर्स एट वेरियस लेवल्स एट मैक्सिमम लेवल्स इन डिसीजन मेकिंग इन डेमोक्रेसी दैट इज पावर शेयरिंग एंड एज वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट पावर शेयरिंग अमंग द पीपल अमंग द इंस्टीट्यूशंस अमंग डिफरेंट सोशल ग्रुप्स इकोनॉमिक ग्रुप्स रिलीजियस ग्रुप्स एटसेट्रा दैट इज द रियल स्पिरिट ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी। ग्रेटर द लेवल ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स बेटर विल बी द क्वालिटी ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी। सो हेयर वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद टू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग इन डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्रीज। वन एग्जाम्पल इज ऑफ बेल्जियम एंड अदर एग्जाम्पल इज ऑफ श्रीलंका। सो लेट अस सी बेल्जियम एंड श्रीलंकाज एग्जाम्पल। बेल्जियम इज ए स्मॉल कंट्री इन यूरोप दैट इज शेयरिंग बॉर्डर्स विद फ्रांस नीदरलैंड्स जर्मनी एंड लग्जमबर्ग। सराउंडेड बाई दीज कंट्रीज दिस स्मॉल कंट्री वी विल टेक द एग्जाम्पल एंड द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ दिस स्मॉल कंट्री इज ओवर 1 करोड़। स्मॉल कंट्री इन साइज एज वेल एज इन पॉपुलेशन। नाउ लेट अस सी द मैप ऑफ बेल्जियम। दिस कंट्री बेल्जियम इन द नॉर्थ नीदरलैंड्स इन द ईस्ट जर्मनी इन साउथ ईस्ट लग्जमबर्ग एंड इन साउथ वी कैन से फ्रांस। सो दिस स्मॉल कंट्री एंड इन वेस्ट द कंट्री इज टचिंग द नॉर्थ सी ऑल्सो द पार्ट ऑफ एटलांटिक ओशन। सो दिस स्मॉल कंट्री बेल्जियम व्हाट इज द सोशल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ बेल्जियम? एज वी नो दैट इन एवरी कंट्री मे बी स्मॉल मे बी लार्ज द सोशल डाइवर्सिटी इज द इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर। इन एवरी कंट्री सोशल डाइवर्सिटी इज फाउंड एवरीवेयर। नाउ लेट अस सी द सोशल डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ बेल्जियम। एट लिंग्विस्टिक लेवल जर्मन स्पीकिंग 19% सॉरी 1%, फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग 40% एंड डच स्पीकिंग 59%। 59% डच स्पीकिंग पीपल 1% जर्मन स्पीकिंग एंड 40% फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग। सो दिस इज द लिंग्विस्टिक डाइवर्सिटी इन दिस कंट्री। द ब्रुसेल्स द कैपिटल ऑफ बेल्जियम द कंडीशन इज डिफरेंट। डच स्पीकिंग 20% एंड फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग 80%। सो इन ब्रुसेल्स फ्रेंच आर इन मेजोरिटी एंड डच आर इन माइनॉरिटी बट इन द होल कंट्री डच आर इन मेजोरिटी एंड कंपेरेटिवली द फ्रेंच पीपल आर इन माइनॉरिटी। आगे चलो दिस इज द सोशल डाइवर्सिटी लिंग्विस्टिक डाइवर्सिटी इन बेल्जियम। आगे बढ़ो बेटा, ना फ्रेंच माइनॉरिटी, व्हाट वाज द स्टेटस, फ्रेंच माइनॉरिटी वाज रिच एंड पावरफुल अपॉन द रिसोर्सेज, द फ्रेंच पीपल दोज हु आर इन माइनॉरिटी दे हैड द दे हैव द कंट्रोल एंड द डच स्पीकिंग दोज हु आर इन मेजोरिटी दे डिड नॉट हैव दिस कंट्रोल अपॉन द रिसोर्सेज. Definitely, this was the region of conflict. This did not like by the Dutch-speaking community because the French, being in minority, they had the control over the resources. And due to this, during 1950 to 1960, 1950s and 60s, tensions between these two communities were normally found in the country. And these tensions were mainly in Brussels, in Brussels, the capital city. Chalo, next. So, as we have already learned, Brussels have a special problem. Dutch speakers were in majority, but minority. The special feature, Brussels' special problem, Dutch speakers were in majority in the country, but minority in Brussels. In Brussels, only 20% Dutch people and 80% French people. Next, chalte raho. Now, see this composition, social composition of Sri Lanka. Iska location dikhani thi pehle. Location, Sri Lanka. An island country to the southeast of India in Indian Ocean. And this country having this different social composition, let us come to this. Chalo, next, social composition. This is the social composition in Sri Lanka. Sinhala speakers. The dominating language is Sinhala, 74%. And Tamil speakers 18%. So Tamils are in minority here and Sinhala speakers are in majority in Sri Lanka. Aage chalo. Chalte rahe agro aage. Now main iska wo to dikha nahi pehle, religious wo nahi dikha iska? Religious composition. Kahan dikha religious? Kahan hai? ये तो लैंग्वेज का हुआ.
ये सर ये रखो
हैं
मैप में देखो सर ये रहा मैप.
हां तो इसमें दिख नहीं रहा ना एथनिक कम्युनिटी, ये इसमें तो दिख ही नहीं रहा, छोटा है ये. या तो इसको बड़ा कर
सर, पीपीटी से काम चल रहा है.
हैं
एंड दिख नहीं कुछ तो बॉय कर.
भाई इसका रिलीजियस कंपोजिशन भी तो था. ओके, सिंगला श्रीलंका, इंडियन तमिल, मुस्लिम तलिम तमिल, क्रिश्चियंस. अच्छा वो लिखा नहीं तूने, चल छोड़ इसको यार. सो दिस फर्दर सी द कंपोजिशन ऑफ सोशल कंपोजिशन, सिंगलाज इन मेजोरिटी, देन श्रीलंकन तमिल्स, इंडियन तमिल्स एंड मुस्लिम्स, ऑल दीज थ्री आर इन माइनॉरिटी. सो मेजोरिटी कम्युनिटी इन श्रीलंका इज सिंगलाज. चल आगे, इसका ठीक नहीं कर रखा तूने. सो व्हाट हैपेंड इन श्रीलंका, टेकिंग द बेनिफिट ऑफ मेजोरिटेरियनिज्म, द सिंगला स्पीकर्स at 74%, the Sri Lankan government took the majoritarian steps in the country. Means that was against the spirit of power sharing. And what were these majoritarian steps taken in Sri Lanka by the government? As we know that this country became independent in 1948, and what were the majoritarian steps taken by the country? First one, they followed the preferential policies that favored Singhalaj. The majority of the people were Singhla, and the government took such steps, those who favored the majority company Singhla. What were these steps? Let us see this. Singhla community secured dominance over the government. Majoritarian dominance by the Singhla community in government, government offices, in political institutions. Chalo aage. What were these majoritarian steps? University positions and government jobs were given to only Singhalaj. Preference was given to Singhla speakers in the government services and in the services and high positions in higher education, I mean in university. Then number two, state shall protect and foster Buddhism as the main religion. State means government will prefer to project and foster Buddhism as the main religion. And this they mentioned in the constitution. एक और था वो स्टेप, कौन सा था तीसरा? पीछे चला गया क्या? एक स्टेप और था तीसरा, मेजोरिटेरियन फॉर द रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ, हाँ यस, एंड थर्ड स्टेप वाज रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ सिंगला एज द ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज. सिंगला ये क्या लिख रखा, फॉर द रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ तमिल एज एन ऑफिशियल. अच्छा वो तूने तीसरा फैक्टर हटा रखा, चल ठीक है. दिस रिएक्शन इन श्रीलंका बाय द तमिल द मेजोरिटेरियन स्टेप्स, डेफिनेटली दीज स्टेप्स वर डिसलाइक्ड बाय द तमिल्स इन श्रीलंका. एंड हाउ दे रिएक्टेड? नंबर वन, दे ऑल्सो कम विद द डिमांड दैट तमिल शुड ऑल्सो बी गिवन द ऑफिशियल status of language, that should also be considered as the language as it was considered for the Singhalaj. And then they also demanded for regional autonomy, for political independence, that regional autonomy. Regional autonomy means in the particular region where Tamil speakers are more, they should be given independence in certain areas of decision making under the control of Sri Lankan government, but at regional level they should be given certain independence, certain independence in different areas. So regional autonomy they demanded. And then for equal opportunities in education and job, in government services and in higher education like in universities, they were also demanding for equal opportunities. And for these justiceful demands, they led their movements by making the political parties, by making the political organizations. But their demands were denied under the dominance of Singhla majoritarianism. Because Singhla people were in majority, Tamil people were in minority. In government there was preference for the Singhalaj. The power of decision making was not shared by the Singhla population, Singhla people with the Tamil people. So this is the example of non-sharing of power with the minorities. Non-sharing of power with the minorities. And result of this, that minority social group, they felt alienated in the country and they had definitely a poor recognition in the country, and they had, the result is that they had the poor respect for the central government and for the system in the country. So this poor respect for the system, for the government, led to the alienation of the Tamil people, of the minority people. Chalo aage. Then what was the result of this reaction of Sri Lankan Tamils? The relations of Sinhalas and Tamils were strained and led to the civil war. The relations were not good relations, and because the Sinhalas were dominating and Tamils had to struggle, had to come on the roads, had to run the movements, had to make the organizations for their justiceful demands. But these demands were not considered by the Sinhalas. And when the relations between the two social groups, two communities were poor, then finally this led to the civil war in the country. And in this civil war, thousands of people were killed and various became refugees in their old country. So end result was the great loss of life and property and peaceful relations in the country in different social groups. It caused a terrible setback to the Sri Lankan economy. And end result, when peace was not there in the country, the two major communities were continuously in conflict and in fight, and this civil war led to the big setback, big loss to the Sri Lankan economy. And not only this, all these events in Sri Lanka led to the degradation and erosion of the Sri Lanka as a nation at international level. At international level, the country was with poor image, the degradation and erosion of the image of the country at international level. So this was due to the non-power sharing in the country. Non-power sharing in the country. It means power sharing in democracy is essential. Chaliye next, chaliye bhai. Now let us see the second example of Belgium as the second example of democratic system or democratic power sharing. Recognize the existence of regional differences. Belgium as a country, as a democratic country, as a democracy, effectively and honestly recognized and registered the existence of regional differences and social differences. And to respect this social diversity and regional diversity, this country between 1970 and 1993, they amended their constitution four times to work out the effective arrangement of power sharing in the constitution. In constitution, such amendments were taken, such provisions were done, which will have the effective power sharing in different social groups, in different regional groups. Let us see what were these steps and how they amended their constitution and what was the end result. That we will discuss under the heading accommodation of social diversity in Belgium. Chalo aage. Elements of Belgian model of power sharing. Let us see these steps or these provisions which were done by the people, by the democracy of Belgium in by amending their constitution, and what were these steps taken? These became the Belgian model of power sharing in our story. Number one, central government, and in central government, as we have already learned, French speaking people 40% in the country and Dutch speaking people 59% in the country. So majority Dutch and minority French, they had this provision that number of ministers in the central government will be equal. 59% Dutch speaking and 40% French speaking, but provision was made equal power at central government. Equal power in central government, number of ministers will be equal. For example, 20 ministers of Dutch community and 20 ministers from French community. Now, second step was there. Many powers of the central government were given to the state governments. The state governments now became more powerful. This was the step for accommodation of regional diversity. At regional level, whatever the small state governments were there, various powers from central government were transferred to the state government. Means now at state level, the people enjoyed more rights. The central government could do better work for the state level. So this was the second provision of Belgian model of power sharing. Third, government, they made at the capital city. So third government, now we have come, first government central level, second government state level, and third government, they made special government for the Brussels. And here in Brussels, because we have seen French were in majority and Dutch were in minority. French 80%, Dutch 20%. But the same model they adopted in Brussels. The equal number of ministers in government of Brussels were kept. 80% French and 20% Dutch. This they accommodated to compensate the number of ministers at central level. Because at central level, 40% French were given the same share in power. But at Brussels level, 20% Dutch were given the same power sharing in this government. 20% Dutch, 20 ministers, and 80% French, they also have 20 ministers. Equal power sharing. So this compensation at central level was done at the level of capital city in the third level of government. So these are the three important steps they took by amending their constitution by effective power sharing at three levels. Central level, state level, and then at the level of capital city Brussels. Aage chalo. Then, fourth step, they made a community government. And this community government was made only for the cultural and educational provisions for the country. To protect the culture of the country and to protect the culture, to protect the minority, the fourth level of government, that was known as community government. And this government was available anywhere in the country. And this government was based only upon the language. Means wherever the people of Belgium, they were living in the country, jahan par bhi wo rehte the, wherever they lived, they were given the provision of third level of government. And the rights of this third level of government were mainly to protect, to upgrade, to foster, to encourage their culture. And through this cultural upgradation activities, cultural upgradation program, they could set up their educational institutions according to their language, their schools, their colleges, their universities. And this फोर्थ लेवल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट विल सुपरवाइज दीज एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस कल्चरल इंस्टीट्यूशंस टू प्रोटेक्ट टू फोस्टर एंड टू एनकरेज देयर कल्चर इन द कंट्री. सो ऑल दीज फोर स्टेप्स ऑफ बेल्जियन मॉडल ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग इन प्रैक्टिकल वी सी दैट दीज लुक कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. दीज स्टेप्स लुक कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बट दे हैव बीन वर्किंग वेरी वेल सो फार इन द कंट्री. एंड वट इज दिस बेल्जियन मॉडल दो लुक कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बट दिस मॉडल हैज बीन वर्किंग वेरी इफेक्टिवली सो फार इन द कंट्री एंड इट हेल्प टू अवॉइड एनी सिविक कंफ्लिक्ट और कम्युनिटी बेस्ड कंफ्लिक्ट और सोशल डाइवर्सिटी बेस्ड कंफ्लिक्ट और लिंग्विस्टिक कंफ्लिक्ट इन द कंट्री एंड एंड रिजल्ट द कंट्री स्टार्टेड टू प्रोग्रेस लीप्स एंड बाउंड्स. द कंट्री स्टार्टेड टू प्रोग्रेस एंड द एंड रिजल्ट एट इंटरनेशनल लेवल दैट दे अर्नड द इफेक्टिव रेस्पेक्ट हाई रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक पावर शेयरिंग एट यूरोप लेवल एज वेल एज एट इंटरनेशनल लेवल. वी कैन सी एट इंटरनेशनल लेवल एज द स्टूडेंट्स इन इंडिया इफ वी आर स्टडीइंग द बेल्जियन मॉडल ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग सो दिस इज द इंटरनेशनल रेस्पेक्ट इंटरनेशनल रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ इफेक्टिव पावर शेयरिंग ऑफ दिस बेल्जियन मॉडल एंड ड्यू टू दिस ब्रुसेल्स द कैपिटल ऑफ बेल्जियम वॉज ऑल्सो मेड द कैपिटल ऑफ यूरोपियन यूनियन. द पार्लियामेंट ऑफ यूरोपियन यूनियन ऑलवेज सिट इन ब्रुसेल्स एंड द होल यूरोप इज गवर्नड बाय दिस सिटी ब्रुसेल्स. सो दिस वाज द इंटरनेशनल रिकॉग्निशन फॉर द बेल्जियन मॉडल ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग. सो नाउ वी कैन सी इन टू डिफरेंट एग्जाम्पल्स वेयर पावर शेयरिंग वॉज इफेक्टिवली डन through constitutional provisions the country socially peacefully politically effectively they started to work and country worked well progressed well and earned the reputation at national level national level continental level and international level and other country like Sri Lanka because power sharing was not done. Power sharing was not done in their constitution and the end result was the civil war, the loss of property, loss of people in the country and erosion to the international image of the country. So we can see the two different examples to have the provisions of power sharing and their outcomes and their results. Aage chalo beta. Yes, already we have done. Brussels became the capital of the European Union.
आज यहीं खत्म कर दो.
क्यों? चल ठीक है यहीं खत्म कर देते हैं.